Well, I think we're nearly ready, and I think this is the first time the bride has ever been on time, which is good news. And John just reminded me, as he was turning his phone off, if we could turn our phones off. And I would like to ask everyone to be upstanding as we welcome the bride and groom. Well, wasn't that, may I say, you both look absolutely radiant and beautiful, and what a wonderful way to start the morning. And good morning to everyone. My name is Glenn Dillon. I'm the pastor here at New Life, and it's great to be here today in the presence of God to witness and celebrate the wedding of John and Sharon. And I know that both John and Sharon are happy that you could all be here to share in this special day. And it's a special day because both John and Sharon have experienced the joy of marriage before, but they've also shared in the sadness of losing the one they love. And so today is a new beginning, and we're excited to share in this special day as they begin their new life together, because both John and Sharon are two very special people. We love them, and it's been a privilege to be a part of their lives so far. And what better way for John and Sharon to do that than being surrounded by the most important people in their lives? And so as I ask you to sit, may you join me in coming before the Lord in prayer. Father God, we come before you today with joy in our hearts, filled of thankfulness and gratitude of what you have done in the lives of both John and Sharon. Thank you that you are a God of love who has loved them and cared for them and guided and been there every step of the way. Thank you, Lord, that you have brought them together today to be married. And Lord, we now pray that this day is a beginning of a new life filled with laughter, fun, and new adventures as they care and support each other in a deeply committed, lifelong, loyal, loving relationship. Lord, may that be a light to the world about your plan for marriage. May today be a celebration of their life, and Lord, may we continue to support them, love them, care them in this new journey together. And we pray that all that we do points to you, and we pray that in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, John and Sharon both wanted me to start by sharing a little bit about marriage, and that marriage for them is one of the most wonderful gifts that were ever given from God. And that right from the very beginning, God designed marriage to be between a man and woman to live in a lifelong relationship of love and commitment. And for both John and Sharon, they have, as we said, shared and enjoyed the blessings of marriage, of children, and the good times and the sad times. The sadness Sharon experienced in losing Ewald, and the sadness John experienced in losing Sandra. But in all this, God works for the good of those who love him. And he has brought John and Sharon together to be married today, because John and Sharon will be better together. It's why Jesus says, what God has joined, let no man separate. You see, for John and Sharon, it's God's plan that their marriage is going to be a relationship that will be deeply committed and honest. It's going to be a relationship that will give them the support they need as you go through life's ups and downs. Friends, it's God who has brought John and Sharon together to be married. And he brings them together with their different families, life experiences, personalities, gifts, and dreams into a brand new relationship that will be united in a life of love and service. And this is why marriage is never just a casual arrangement so we're no longer lonely, but it's a sacred covenant which is made before God and everyone here. Therefore, marriage is entered into with real commitment, and it will be grounded in the love and grace of God. But the truth is, our culture is now rejecting this idea of marriage, isn't it? Because marriage is now anything you want it to be, and that it's all about feelings, and so it's something you can leave when the going gets tough. And this is why many marriages don't make it, and why people are choosing not to get married, because marriage is no longer seen as a wonderful gift given from God, and that marriage is God's idea, and so it's to be done God's way for our benefit. And this is why John and Sharon said we need to start by going back to the very beginning, where the Bible tells us that God created all things, and then he created Adam and Eve to be in an intimate relationship with him and with each other. And then God told them not to eat from the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. God said, eat from any other tree in the garden, but trust me, this is a good command. It's for your benefit. And so don't eat from this one tree or you'll surely die. And what did they do? Well, they ate, just like we all would have. And instead of trusting God, they believed that God wasn't good. They'd be better off trusting themselves. And the consequence of that is that their eyes were open, they saw they were naked, and instantly hid in shame from each other and from God. You see, that's what sin does. It actually destroys everything, including how marriage was meant to be. And now every single person that's ever been born is born outside the garden, outside of a relationship with God, with a desire to love ourselves, to follow our feelings. And because of sin, people are in a mess, relationships are in a mess, marriages are in a mess, and the world is now in a mess, and death is the ultimate mess we end up in. You see, that's the bad news. And it's actually bad news for everyone, because the Bible says that we're all born separated from God. We're all born unable to save or change ourselves. And it's why we need the good news of Jesus Christ. That God, in his great love for humanity, would send Jesus, his one and only Son, who came and lived the perfect life we couldn't and died the death we should have, so people could be forgiven and saved and brought back into a relationship with God. You see, because God is perfect and he's holy and he's good, he couldn't let our sin and rejection of him go unpunished. And this is why Jesus, who is God's very own Son, said, I'll take that punishment. And I can take it because I've never sinned. You see, it's on the cross that Jesus died to save us so we could be brought back into a relationship with him. And that's what's happened to John and Sharon. That's what they wanted you to share with you today, that they've put their trust in Jesus and now they want to live God's way in God's world. And it's why today is a great day for them both, because Jesus has saved them. It's Jesus who's been with them every step of the way through the good times and the sad times. And it is Jesus who will continue to hold them together. And John and Sharon, when marriage is lived out like this, your marriage will become a witness in a world full of marriages that are dominated by selfishness, based on lust, not love, full of greed, not grace, quick to judge, slow to forgive, wanting to be served and not serve. And this is why, John, you are called to love Sharon as Jesus loved the church, because it's a love that never fails. And it's why, Sharon, you are to love and support John, because you are better together. And so let me encourage you both as you continue to look to Jesus in all that you do. Let his word lead you and guide you. And I know this is how you both are entering into marriage today, and I know you are both excited to begin your journey and new life together. And that is why I'd like now to invite Vance, a close friend, and he's going to come up and lead us in a time of prayer and blessing for both Sharon and John. Thanks, Vance.
May I lead you in prayer. Gracious Heavenly Father, we give you thanks for the joining together of John and Sharon in marriage today. We pray that together they will keep their eyes fixed on you, because you are the one that holds all things together. You have created all things, the visible and the invisible. All things have been created for your glory. Even before the creation of the world, you had a perfect plan for each and every one of our lives, a plan for us to be redeemed and forgiven of our sin, a plan to bring unity to all things in heaven and on earth. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the gift of marriage. Thank you that marriage is an example of your unconditional love for us, in that you would lay down your life for us to save us from our sin, so that one day we may live with you in heaven forever. We pray that John would love Sharon unconditionally, protect her, encourage her, and build her up in faith. Listen to her carefully and speak to her with words that are gentle and humble. Heavenly Father, we pray for Sharon, that she will love John selflessly in a way that honors you. May she be persistent in prayer for John and their marriage as she continues to follow you and keep you first in her life. Gracious God, we pray that John and Sharon remain focused on you. We know that marriage works best when we seek you for wisdom and guidance. Our prayer is for your help for them to remember this, and please give them the strength to seek you always so that their marriage will honor you. Lord God, we also pray for John and Sharon's church family. Help us to help them in their marriage so that we may encourage and love and support them in the days ahead. We thank you that we can share in this special day with them. We thank you that this day is all about you and what you have done for us. Thank you for the commitment that John and Sharon will soon make in your presence in front of all of us here today. And we pray for your blessing on their marriage as they begin their new journey together. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Well, thank you, Vance. Well, John and Sharon, you are deeply loved by God, and God has brought you here together to be married. You are surrounded by your wonderful and loving and caring and supporting family and friends. So now I would like to ask you both to come up and join me on the stage and share your vows together. We practice this, remember? And take him by the hands. Yeah. Okay. John, in the presence of God and before your family and friends, do you take Sharon to be your lawfully wedded wife?
I do.
Not yet. You don't know, you haven't agreed to everything yet. Okay, you ready? Do you promise to love and care for her? Do you promise to accept her with all her faults and strengths? John, will you support Sharon when she needs help? And each day, will you put her needs ahead of your own? And will you always keep the promises you are making to her today as long as you both shall live?
I will.
Very good. Then John, repeat after me.
I, John Vincent, receive you, Sharon Klinkenberg, to be my wife in Christian marriage, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death do us part. In the presence of God, I make this solemn promise.
Sharon, in the presence of God and before your family and friends, do you take John to be your lawfully wedded husband? Do you promise to love and care for him? Do you promise to accept him with all his faults and strengths? Sharon, will you help John when he needs help? Will you put his needs ahead of your own? And will you always keep the promises you are making to him today as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Then Sharon, repeat after me. She nearly slapped me.
I, Sharon Klinkenberg, receive you, John Vincent, to be my husband and in Christian marriage, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death do us part, in the presence of God, I make this solemn promise.
Okay, John, it's now it's time to give the rings. You got them? Okay, give Sharon those. Yep. John and Sharon, these rings you are giving to each other will serve as a symbol of the promises you've just made. They are an outward sign of an invisible love that binds you together. And so, John, say after me, Sharon.
Sharon.
I give you this ring
as a symbol
of my lifelong love and faithfulness to you.
Of my lifelong love and faithfulness to you.
Just spin it a bit. You got there. All right, Sharon, say after me.
John.
John.
I give you this ring.
I give you this ring
as a symbol.
As a symbol. Of my lifelong love and faithfulness to you.
John and Sharon, you've made your promises to each other before God and before all of us. Therefore, according to the will of God, the laws of this land and of the church, it's my honor and privilege to declare that you are now husband and wife. In the name of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, what God has joined together, let no man separate. It's now time to kiss the bride. Wonderful, wonderful. Well, it's time for us to sign the register, and can I ask the people who are going to witness to come and do that as well? Move over here.
Come thou fount of every blessing, tune my heart to sing thy grace. Streams of mercy never ceasing, call for songs of loudest praise. Teach me some melodious sonnet, sung by flaming tongues above. Praise the mount, I'm fixed upon it, mount of thy redeeming love. Here I raise my Ebenezer, here by thy great help I've come, and I hope by thy good pleasure, safely to arrive at home. Jesus sought me when a stranger, wandering from the fold of God. He to rescue me from danger, interposed his precious blood. Precious blood. That day when freed from sinning, I shall see thy lovely face. Clothed then in blood-washed linen, how I'll sing thy sovereign grace. Come, my Lord, no longer tarry, take my ransom soul away. Send thine angels now to carry me to realms of endless days. Oh, to grace, how great a debtor daily I am constrained to be. Let thy goodness, like a fetter, bind my wandering heart to thee. Prone to wander, Lord, I feel it. Prone to leave the God I love. Here's my heart, oh, take and seal it. Seal it for thy courts above. Here's my heart, oh, take and seal it. Seal it for thy courts above. Come, thou fount of every blessing, tune my heart to sing thy grace. Streams of mercy never ceasing call for songs of loudest praise. Teach me some melodious sonnet sung by flaming tongues above. Praise the mount I'm fixed upon it, mount of thy redeeming love. Here I raise my Ebenezer, here by thy great help I've come, and I hope by thy good pleasure safely to arrive at home. Jesus sought me when a stranger, wandering from the fold of God. He to rescue me from danger interposed his precious blood. Precious blood. Oh, that day when freed from sinning, I shall see thy lovely face. Clothed then in blood-washed linen, how I'll sing thy sovereign grace. Come, my Lord, no longer tarry, take my ransom.
Well, that's the paperwork done. Well, it is my great privilege for the very first time to present to all of you Mr. and Mrs. John and Sharon Vincent. May I give them a round of applause.
You're my peace of mind.
You're done. And as they walk out, they would love to invite you to stay in the hall. There's some wonderful light refreshments where we can continue to celebrate together this wonderful marriage.
You're everything I've tried to find. Your love is a pearl. You're my moment. You're my rainbow skies, and my only prayer is that you realize you'll always be